You have molded me to become a better teacher.
I've played with Janardhan ji for more than 25 years.
His contribution is really great.
His name is synonymous with sitar.
You've been such a wonderful soul.
He played for so many music directors.
Great musicians, love.
So whenever you hear some sitar, it is mainly Pandit Mitta's sitar, which you hear in the South Indian films.
Guruji has given 60 years service.
He has contributed immensely.
He has been a great musician, great composer, great companion, great patron.
Namaskaram. I'm at the home of the sitar maestro, Pandit Janardhan Mitta ji. Pandit ji is a noted musician who has learned the sitar under the world-renowned sitar maestro, Bharat Ratna Pandit Ravi Shankar ji. Pandit ji has contributed to the South Indian film industry with numerous songs and background scores. I'll be talking today to Pandit ji about his early days in Hyderabad, his learning with Pandit Ravi Shankar ji, his move to Chennai and becoming part of the South Indian film industry, and his life as a musician and a sitar player. Namaskaram Panditji, it is truly a pleasure and a privilege to be talking to you here today. Thank you for receiving me.
I'm happy to receive you, coming as you do from Amsterdam, Holland, all the way to know more about our Indian culture and Indian music. You're most welcome, sir.
Panditji, can you please share with us some of your early days in Hyderabad and how you were introduced to classical music and meeting the sitar maestro, Pandit Ravi Shankarji?
Yes, I'll be very happy to do that. I'm born and brought up in Hyderabad. And my father was a great legal luminary, but he was so much interested in music that any classical musician who comes to Hyderabad will come home and sing. So from my childhood, I was exposed to very good classical music. You know, in those days, Friday used to be a holiday during the Nizam's period. So Thursday evening, my father would close off his office, sit with six brothers we have. He will take harmonium, one will take tabla and all that. And the musicians who come from outside Hyderabad, they will come and sing for us. So that way I was exposed to music very much. The music was very much in me. After some time, my elder sister, before marriage, as an additional qualification, you know, she learned sitar for some time. And after getting married, she left the sitar and went to her in-law's place. One fine morning, I just did namaskaram in the puja room and then lifted the sitar. Music was within me and I started playing sitar.
Just like that.
Without knowing much of the technique.
Mm-hmm.
But it was, phonetically it was very good. The rag was okay, the tar was okay, mm-hmm. and the mind and all this. With the result that I was selected as a radio artist. It was called Deccan Radio in those days.
Mm-hmm.
Deccan Radio.
Yes, yes.
So I was selected there as a child artist first, then I started playing. So only in 1952, when it merged with the Indian Union, the great masters like Pandit Ratan Janakarji
mm-hmm.
and Pandit Virendra Kishore Chaudhary, very great musicians, they came to standardize the artist's thing. And in that audition, I was placed in a grade higher than the local sitar master there.
Yes.
So it was, as an amateur, it was very good. And in the year 1955, for Sangeet Sammelan, my Guruji, my Udupi Guruji,
mm-hmm.
Pandit Ravi Shankarji came here.
Yes.
And I was introduced to him as a local sitar artist. Acha sitar bajate kya? So next time when he come, I will visit him. And as he said, next time he heard me. And he said, very beautifully he put it, saying that, you seem to know some of the advanced things without knowing some basics.
Mm.
What he meant was, phonetically, I mean, your rag is correct, your taal is correct, your is correct. But there are some basic things to be used in the strokes.
Mm.
They're like, diri da, diri da ra, da da ra. I used to play da ra da.
Mm.
Phonetically, both are same. So he said that when you don't even the basic like this, it means that. And in all the instances, I said, that's where I need Guruji, I said. Acha sikha jao dekha. I was doing second year of engineering at that time. My father, again, he encouraged me. He said, Panditji, if you are taking Janardhan as your disciple, I don't mind his giving up engineering, which was a very great goal. He was surprised. Guruji is 5'5", my father was 6'2". He looked at him and said that, oh, are you crazy? He said, yes, I am crazy about music. Anybody can become an engineer, but not all have the talent to this. I find this boy, and if he's going to be under you, I don't mind his giving up. That was the first boon that I got from him. And once he started teaching, earlier as an amateur, I used to keep music under my control and study.
Mm.
But after going to Guruji, it became very difficult. All the time music was there.
Mm.
I'm finding it very difficult for classical music and engineering to be continued.
Mm.
And as God sent, on the 6th June 1958, Sarathi studio, the first film studio was opened here.
In Hyderabad.
In Hyderabad. A day prior to that, my brother was elder brother, a very good singer, excellent singer. He was singing for that music director to get a chance for playback singing. Mm-hmm. Behind him, I sit there as playing a little sitar accompanying him.
So that was by chance that you brought him to film?
Yeah, that was changing, game-changing this thing. Mm-hmm. When I went there, first recording on 6th June 1958, mm-hmm. I played in Sarathi Studios. The moment I played, all the musicians, particularly Krishnasila and Gantasala, they all said, oh, it's so nice, you know, so we don't have anybody in Chennai, he must come up. Mm-hmm. I did not jump at the idea. Mm-hmm. Then another music director, Ashwadhama, came. He also heard me and he said, we need you. So for about 6 months, I was debating within myself. And I thought, instead of engineering and classical music, I thought film music and classical music may gel better. Mm. So why not I take a chance?
Yeah. So Pandeji, so when did you come to Chennai exactly then?
19th January 1959. Arrived here on the 20th January.
Yes.
And since then there was no looking back.
Yeah.
But as I arrived, all the music directors felt that if I played for Mr. Venu and Ashwatthama and all those people, he was the one. And just by the word of mouth, it spread like anything. And you will not believe that there is no music director since then. Mm-hmm. I have played for all the music directors,
yes,
in all the four South Indian languages.
Yeah.
Because Malayalam, Kannada, Tamil and Telugu used to be here only. Yeah. So I played all the music directors right from Jiran, Adair, up to even.
Do you remember some of the films you played for?
Numerous films.
Yeah.
I don't know. Wherever your sitar is heard,
yeah,
I think it, I would have played.
Because you played film songs and background scores.
Background scores. Background score, I was a little specialist in the sense, mm-hmm, that according to the scene I will go and according to music, where the music ends and where the next music ends, I used to give a sort of link. So they were so confident in me. Every music director had different tastes, but I was able to cater to all the music director tastes.
Yeah.
And that continued up to the latest musicians. Even from music directors from Bombay, like Bombay Ravi and Salil Chaudhary, mm-hmm, when they come here, from there itself they phone me, please Janardhan, can you block these dates for our recording?
Mm-hmm.
Then Odisha, Bengali, Ceylonese, mm-hmm, and even one English film I have played.
Mm-hmm.
This was produced by former President B.V. Giri's son, Shankar Giri.
Mm-hmm.
Epistle,
mm-hmm,
that is a letter, mm-hmm, in which Madam Jayalalitha ji acted. She was just 14 at that time,
uh-huh,
in the convent.
Yeah.
And she spoke English so beautifully well.
Yes.
And I said, oh, this girl will go places. And as I thought, it happened like that only. So that was how it happened.
Yeah.
Till the language films moved, Telugu,
mm-hmm,
Tamil is here, Telugu, Kannada and Malayalam.
Mm-hmm.
For some time I used to go there, but after that I stopped going from there.
Mm-hmm.
And lately, what has happened is, like A.R. Rahman or Ilayaraja,
mm-hmm,
so when they asked me to come for the film shows, on the stage.
Yes.
I said in the studios it's okay.
Yeah.
Because on the stage I'm a classical musician.
Yes.
Being a disciple of the great Pandit Ravi Shankar Ji,
mm-hmm,
I have been performing solo performances,
mm-hmm,
and many jugalbandis, his followers like M.S. Gopalkrishnan Ji, T.N. Krishnan Ji,
mm-hmm,
Kanyakumari, Ravi Kiran, and all that, and to the accompaniment of Umayalpur, Shivaraman Ji, T.B. Gopalkrishnan Ji, and all that. So that standard of this thing I made. But at the same time, I took a little plunge into fusion music also, with the film background and the classical background.
Yeah.
The fusion was the most natural thing.
Yes.
So without giving too much importance to the Western style, I maintained some of my own characteristics, this thing. I'm trying to do that also. And most of the devotional songs are private songs. I used to play for all of them.
Mm-hmm. So with your busy schedule playing for films in Chennai and your Guruji traveling all over the world, how did you maintain
the class? That's a very fine, good question. But as I told you, I was self-taught musician, already selected and performing and all that. So actually in the year 56 when I met you, went to Delhi for this thing, that was the year when Guruji resigned his post from the AR and his travels abroad started. So whenever we meet in Delhi, Varanasi, sometimes in Chennai, sometimes in Hyderabad, so he will have master classes because we are all advanced students. So he will be, in my case, he will be looping, he will plug in the loop for as it was. So it, what he tells in one raga, we will apply it to other ragas. In fact, he used to say, I give you so much, but you make it so much. What is applicable in one raga? See, teaching has been more off and on,
yes.
But was such great this thing that I could make great strides in classical music. And with that, I was able to go abroad also.
Yes.
In the year 1967 itself, first I went to Europe as a member of the youth delegation. And there we had 27 countries participate in France. India was the only country where the first show was sold. So I had to put up an extra show.
Yes.
That was the popularity which Guruji brought, and there I performed in TV. And that year I went to Poland, Germany, London, Brazil, and all over Europe we came. And again in the 1971, Sri Ghantasala, the great singer, he had a tour of the America by the Telugu, by some Telugu people here there. So when we went there, we saw that from 400 to 500 miles away, all the people were coming to listen to them. And that was the reason for formation of the Telugu associations there,
yes.
Later. So we started that one. And on that year, we had the opportunity to perform in the UNO also,
yes.
In the year 1971.
Yeah.
And earlier, in 1976, I was the first Hindustani musician to perform in Sagar Aradhana. Dr. Balamurli Krishnaji, he told me to perform there. I learned two kirtanas from him and performed.
Yes.
That was the highlight of that year's program.
Yeah. So, Panditji, in the 1990s, you were the president of the Sindh Musicians Union. Can you tell me something more about that?
You see, this is one of the best unions that we have. All the Sindh musicians, till 1967 when we formed the association, there was no security for them, for the parents and all that. You'll be surprised when you visit that our demands included 9 don'ts and only 1 yes. Then we don't want you to pick us up from our house. We don't want you to provide breakfast for us. You don't want us to give lunch for us. We'll come on our own, we'll take care of everything and all that. All that you have to do is, at the end of the recording, you must make the payment to build on the spot. Otherwise, we had a hell of a problem. After completion, the film is not very successful, the producer may vanish also.
Yeah.
They may be locked. So they were surprised, you know, it's such a good this thing. We don't have to bother about picking you up and all that, you know. So from then it became very good.
Yeah.
And after that, we started welfare schemes and all that. So in the year 1991, I went for the general body meeting, but everybody unanimously elected me as the president. And after becoming the president, I made a pension scheme for the retiring musicians. After 60 days, give it in writing that they have not played the films. Will be given pension.
You also joined the Rotary.
Yeah.
Why did you personally join?
Main attraction was, they take only the leaders in every field. So my field of this thing, I was the leading. I found that I have been moving mostly in the music circles only, and my interests are wide. So I go to the book club and earlier education and all that. So there, different classification of people will come. And this is the best way of serving the people. Yes. And what a different classification of people. There'll be doctors, lawyers, there'll be engineers, business people, and all those, you know. I wanted that side.
Yeah. Pandiji, currently your main focus is only your classical music and teaching.
Yeah.
I have understood that you teach students from many countries from around the world. Can you share your experiences with your foreign students in particular?
Yeah. We had quite a few students from abroad. I would like to mention one about a Thailand student. He used to come like our own people, Juba Paitama. He was doing MA in Sanskrit. And later he became a professor of Sanskrit in this college here. So he used to come and learn from me. Like there somebody from Canada came.
Yes.
Then we had, from various countries, we hang out.
Were there any challenges teaching foreign students compared to the local students?
No, those who are interested only, they used to come.
In sitar or any?
Yes.
Yeah.
One of the students, he did MS in UK.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, I'm not finding happiness in anything except music.
Yeah.
He came and learned for some time. And then he joined this Isha Yogi, you know?
Yes, yes.
Then he has given the name as the Kevala. He is working there.
Yeah.
And he plays the sitar there for Guruji, Sadhguru. Like that, there are many experiences. And I give on Skype also.
Yes.
Skype also, they are giving the classes.
Yes.
And it's very nice, you know. Lately, for the past 5 years or so, one student, Mr. Abhishek, is coming from Malaysia. He has got a very big institution there, teaching dance and our music, maintaining our culture, spreading there here. Every year he has got a very annual function. So he comes to me very often, stays here for some time, learns the sitar, and is now capable of performing on his own also. So right now he happens to be here.
Okay.
So we have classes here.
Yes.
And after that, he will go and perform in all the things.
Okay. So would it be possible for me to watch?
Sure.
Class?
Sure. Now, Abhishek, we'll start with a prayer which Guruji has composed.
Yeah. the alap and all that. Now we'll start with this thing. We conclude with a tihai, where the tabla will answer or something. What why I play, you repeat. Only at the end you come back. Okay?
Pleasantly surprised to see you in a class with your Guruji. Can you tell me something about your experiences learning from Guruji?
The experience was really blessing. I feel blessed all the while in every session. I feel very fortunate to meet Guruji and know about you and to come in the lineup of Panditji Ravishankar, and you are the right disciple, and it's passed over to me, and I will definitely pass it over to the next generation. So thank you for giving me the opportunity.
God bless you
for being your disciple.
So Guruji, thank you so much for sharing your time with me, and it's truly a pleasure and a privilege for me to be here and to meet you up so closely. I have a small gift for you.
Thank you so much. So very thoughtful of you to have taken the interview and for the presentation. He is doing quite well, very interested. I wish him all the best.
It's an honorable pleasure to dedicate this biography of my guru to the world. Thank you so much, Guruji, for giving me this opportunity to create this documentary. Thank you so much for teaching me the sitar. You have inspired me so much. You have molded me to become a better teacher. I wish you a long, healthy life. My pranams, Guruji.
I've played with Janardhanji for more than 35 years. And when I started my first film, Roja, and then Pudhiyamugam, you might have heard his amazing sitar sound. It's so delicate and beautiful. He's been part of my music the whole of 90s, 2000. So I wish him the very best. And I want to thank God for the gift God has given to Janardhanji, playing the sitar for me. God bless.
Namaskar. My name is Samuel J. Das, and today I would really like to congratulate Master Janardhan. I came to know about him in my teens because my father used to talk about him when he went to India. I think he met him and he took some lessons also from him. And my master, Mr. Maheshwaran Om, also used to talk about him because even he took some lessons before he went to Pandit Ravishankar. So he's quite a well-known name in the music fraternity, and not only that, his contribution in the world of film industry is also great because he has played with so many composers like Ilaiyaraja, A.R. Rahman, and even M.S. Viswanathan, and so many stalwarts he has played with, and his contribution is really great, and I really feel very honored to say a few words about him. In fact, one of my students, his name is Abhishek, also went and learnt under him. I'm very glad about that, and anyway, I would like to congratulate him again, and may God bless him with longevity and also more accomplishments.
Namaskaram.
Namaskaram.
I am Natyacharya, VP Dhananjayan.
I am Shanta Dhananjayan, his wife.
We know Pandit Janardhanan Anna almost now 50 years. We knew about Pandit Janardhanan sir because his name is synonymous with sitar as far as South India is concerned. He has been in the film world for a long time, music and film orchestration. There is no songs without
his resonant sound.
Exactly. Some of our major productions like Jungle Book, for which Pandit Vijay Raghava Rao, Guru Bhai, for Janardhanan Anna, we have involved him, and all through those productions, his sitar's vibration is very, very nostalgic to us as well as for everybody who has listened to those wonderful music provided by those stalwarts. So when Pandit Vijay Raghava Rao comes here for recording for our productions, the first name he will mention is, I want Janardhanan for my orchestration. So that is how Janardhanan, Pandit Janardhanan sitar is famous in the South Indian industry, the music industry as well as film industry. He is such a down-to-earth person. We like him because he's so humble and very genuine and simple man, a best human being. Janardhanan Anna always comes and listens to South Indian music series, and also he comes for our programs.
Yes.
That is something that is we always remember. So
I shows such this great interest in all the aspects of music.
Yes. So we wish him Ayur Arogya Saukhyam. We are very happy that a documentary is being made on him, and we are part of that. It is an honor for us to take part in that journey of making a documentary on such a great
artist.
And
we won't be. Yes. Wonderful.
Even though he, Hindustani music, his interest in South Indian Carnatic music is also great. So we wish him, actually we seek his blessings. He is elder to me, so we call him Anna. So all the best to him, and also once again wish him Ayur Arogya Saukhya.
My pranams to Guruji. I'm so glad to be part of this video. You've been such a wonderful soul, appreciated me in everything I do in dance. I wish you long life, Guruji.
It's a great pleasure to say a few things about my good friend, Mr. F. Janardhan, sitarist, very famous sitarist, well-known sitarist, and he worked very hard in the film industry. He used to practice a lot those days because very few people have touch in both cinema and classical music. For example, singer like Mr. K.J. Yesudas, he was busy in cinema industry as a songster. At the same time, he was giving concerts, classical music concerts, South Indian music. Likewise, Mr. Janardhan was very busy in cinema and giving Hindustani concerts within India and overseas. I first met him in Moonar Studios 50 years back, I think, along with Chitti Babu. Mr. Chitti Babu was a very, very big veena player those days. He is no more. He has got so many disciples. Both were very good friends. So we were playing for Mr. Pandurangan. That was in Moona Studios. In different languages they produced that film. Jana was a very good sitar player. He played for so many music directors in Hindi and all languages. For many music directors he played. Irrespective of music has no language. So he played for different music directors, including Salil Chaudhary. Mr. Salil Chaudhary was a great music director in Hindi. He used to come here to do Malayalam films. I was assisting him. So there also he was loved by Mr. Salil Chaudhary and even for other music directors in Hindi. And here for Telugu, Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada, Hindi, like that. So for so many people he played. And he was doing some social work also through Lions Club. And I always remember Jana because one of my songs is very popular, like My Nagam in Trishna from Malayalam film. That many songs he played for me, but that particular song, it starts with sitar because the heroine plays the sitar. So that number is very popular, starts from sitar, and even in interludes also very famous, they're very lovable, very nice to hear. So anyway, it is for a good purpose. Jana should be known to people now with very good technology. People's name, people's talent should come out. It is coming out. So I wish Jana all the best. So let him have a long life. God bless Jana Bhai. I used to call him Jana Bhai. God bless Mr. Janardhan. God bless his music. God bless his family. Thank you.
Namaskaram. Shri Guru Pyo Namaha. I'm Srimati Parvati Ravi Gantasala, a Bharatanatyam artist. It gives me great pleasure to know Pandit Mitta Janardhan uncle. I know him for more than 3 decades. He has contributed immensely for the Indian musical industry. And also he has performed extensively along with my father-in-law, Padmashri Gantasala Garu. Very humble and a wonderful human being. He would have got many, many awards, but along with that, we, Gantasala family, had honored him with Kala Pradeshni Gantasala Puraskar. We are very proud to have another legend in our family. Thank you.
Namaskar. I am Dr. Nagaraja Havaldar, Hindustani classical musician living in Bangalore. I have known Pandit Janardhan Ji for the last 3 decades. He has been a great musician, great composer, great companion, great patron. What else you can say about him? Well, one thing strikingly common between him and myself is both our Gurujis. Pandit Ravi Shankar, the guru of Janardhan Ji, and Pandit Bhimsen Joshi, my guru's guru, both of them were bestowed Bharat Ratna, the highest civilian award, for their contribution to Indian classical music. As the successors to the great tradition, it leaves great responsibility on the shoulders of people like us. And Pandit Janardhan Ji has very successfully carried on the mantle of Pandit Ravi Shankar. Well, Pandit Janardhan Ji is a kind of epitome for sitar, or a synonym for sitar in Chennai. Name it and he's pretty much there, whether it is classical music or film music, composing, organizing, arranging, everything, he has handled it exceedingly well. And he has had the privileges of giving jewel bandis with great people like MSG, PN Krishnan Ji, just to name a few. That means it requires a total understanding of both the systems, both the instruments, and their sense of proportion and whatnot. And Pandit Janardhanji is the only sitar player, probably, or the first sitar player to play at the Theravada Charyarajavatsava. I have heard a few of his concerts. When you listen to his Chavakesi, his Meend, his Gamak, his Alap, his Jamjama are very sincere, very serious, very subtle, flowing like an ocean. And when you shift from Chavakesi to Sindhu Bhairavi, his chromatic approach to both the Rishabh, both the Dandas, both the Madhyam, both the Dhaivats, both the Nishad is very aesthetic and very beautiful. So his command over instrument, his command over chikari, his command over laikari is all exceedingly beautiful. Indeed, it's my honor and privilege to be speaking about Pandit Janardhan Mittaji in this global documentary that's being produced on him.
Kondamandiki, vaalla inti peru kanna vaalla vrutti peru cheptana gurtimpu maa cinema industry lo atundi great musicians lo Tabla Prasad, Shahnai Satchangaru, Sitar Janardhan, ilaga డ్రమ్ శివమణి అనగానే వాళ్ళ ఇంటి పేరే ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్గా మార్చుకున్నటువంటి మహానుభావుల్లో చాలా సీనియర్ మోస్ట్ అండ్ మాకు చాలా మంచి ఫ్యామిలీ ఫ్రెండ్ పండిట్ జనార్దన్ గారు. మన సితారంగానే అంతకుముందు గుర్తొచ్చేది పండిట్ రవిశంకర్, తర్వాత సినిమా అనగానే సితార్ ఎంతమంది ప్లే చేసినా సితార్ జనార్దన్ గారనే ఆయన స్థిరపడ్డారు. నాకన్నా చాలా సీనియర్ ఆయన, ఆయన కనీసం ఆ పాతికేళ్ళు నాకన్నా ముందు ఇండస్ట్రీకి వచ్చారు ఆయన, అంటే దగ్గర దగ్గర 60 ఏళ్ళు దాటే. అదృష్టం ఏంటంటే ఆయనతో కలిసి ఎన్నో రికార్డింగ్స్కి నేను కీబోర్డ్ పేరుగా పనిచేశాను చాలామంది సంగీత దర్శకుల దగ్గర. తర్వాత నేను సంగీత దర్శకుడిని అయిన తర్వాత నా మొట్టమొదటి పాట నుంచి అంటే హై హై నాయక నుంచి ఎన్నో సినిమాలకి, అంతేకాకుండా ఈటీవీకి మేము చేసిన సీరియల్స్కి కానీ ఎన్నో వాటికి ఆయన వాయిస్ సహకారం అందించడం నేను చేస్తున్న అదృష్టం. ఆయనే కాదు ఆయన కుటుంబ సభ్యులు, మా కుటుంబ సభ్యులు చాలా సన్నిహితంగా ఉంటాం. చాలా గొప్ప వ్యక్తి, నిగర్వి, డౌన్ టు ఎర్త్. ఇంకోళ్ళు అంత లెవెల్లో ఉన్నవాళ్ళు నాలాంటి వాళ్ళతో కొంత డిస్టెన్స్ మెయింటైన్ చేస్తారు జనరల్గా సినిమా అనేప్పటికీ. కానీ జనార్దన్ గారి దగ్గర నేను 48 ఏళ్ల క్రితం చూసిన జనార్దన్ గారు ఎలా ఉన్నారో ఇవాళ కూడా అలాగే ఉన్నారు. చాలా గొప్ప వ్యక్తి, గొప్ప విద్వాంసులే కాకుండా ఒక పద్ధతులు ఉన్న ఫ్యామిలీ, వాళ్ళ ఫ్యామిలీ అది చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్. అలాగే సినిమా ఇండస్ట్రీలో మాకు సినీ మ్యూజిషియన్స్ యూనియన్ కూడా ప్రెసిడెంట్గా చేశారు. అంతేకాకుండా 4 తరాలు చూశారు ఆయన, 4 తరాలు చూసిన ఏకైక వ్యక్తి మా సితార జనార్దన్ గారు. ఆయన ఆరోగ్యంగా ఐశ్వర్యంతో, ఐశ్వర్య భవంతులు అలాగే ఇచ్చాడు, ఆరోగ్యంగా జీవించాలని చెప్పి ఆయన, ఆయన కుటుంబ సభ్యులు అన్ని రకాలుగా బాగుండాలని మనస వాచ కర్మణ నేను భగవంతుని కోరుకుంటున్నాను. మీ మాధోపిత్ సురేష్.
నమస్కార్. విత్ ఎ గ్రేట్ ప్లెజర్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు టాక్ అబౌట్ వన్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ వెరీ రెస్పెక్టెడ్ మ్యూజిషియన్ పండిత్ Janardhan Mitta. Those who have really worked hard in South India to popularize Hindustani classical or North Indian classical music in the South, Pandit Janardhan Mitta's name comes in the foremost place. In 2000, he started Vishwa Kala Sangama, an organization to promote North Indian classical music amongst the music lovers and music loving people of South India, where North Indian music were relatively not popular and people didn't know about that music very much. He organized many concerts to promote Hindustani classical music along with his North Indian friends and South Indian musicians. I have also had the privilege of performing in his academy and his music concerts with him, and also as a solo performer. So we are very happy that a documentary is being done on his name, and I wish all the success for this documentary. This will be a great work, because a person like Pandit Janardhan Mitta needs to be remembered in the history of Indian classical music for popularizing, for the trouble he has taken to popularize Hindustani classical music, not only in the South but all over the world. And also as an accomplished sitar player and very well-known sitar player who has also performed in South Indian music and in South Indian films. So whenever you hear some sitar, it is mainly Pandit Mitta's sitar which you hear in the South Indian films. We wish all the best. Thank you. Namaskar.
Namaskaram. I am Ishwar Rao, disciple of Kalaimamani Pandit Janardhan Mitta sir, who is direct disciple of sitar icon Pandit Ravi Shankar sir. Guruji has given 60 years service in classical, filmy and devotional round the globe. In classical, he has played many jugalbandis with top artists. On other sides, in films, he has played in multi-language movies and he has played for many multi-music directors till the latest music directors like Rahman, Haris Jayaraj and others. Today we hear Suprabhatam in Tirumala Tirupati. It is being played by my Guruji. I am so proud to be his disciple. Thank you so much.
Hi, Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Let me first thank you for this wonderful opportunity given to me to speak a few words about my Guru, Pandit Janardhan Mitta ji. As a child, I've been very fascinated towards the sitar and always wanted to learn playing the sitar, but it never happened. Sometime in 2005, I had gone to one of his concerts. That day his playing was amazing, out of the world. Soon after the concert was over, I went backstage and spoke to him and told him and expressed my desire to learn the sitar. Without any hesitation, he gave me his visiting card and told me to come and meet him. The very next day, I was there at his class. That's how my class started. Very, very simple, very soft-spoken, and very, very patient while teaching his students. Basically, I'm a Carnatic student and never knew anything about the instrument or the Hindustani music. He taught me so patiently. A person of his stature, being so humble, very unassuming, it's very hard to find a guru like him. I pray to God to bless him with many, many more years of playing the sitar. A very happy, long life. Once again, pranam to you, sir. Thank you so much.
I am Mrs. Kalyani Shastri, learning from Mr. Janardhan Mitta ji, who is the most eminent musician, a sitarist in Chennai. And I am very grateful that I got a very good guru, who is a student of the great maestro Pandit Ravi Shankar ji. Even during this lockdown, my guru has not stopped teaching me. We still continue our classes through Skype, and I'm very fortunate to have this guru. And I'm so lucky to be under his tutelage. I think I can learn as much as I can. And I think learning is a process, life process, and one should keep learning. Thank you.
Namaste. This is Lakshmi and Vishnu. We both are Carnatic musicians living in Chennai. It gives us a lot of pleasure to talk about our experiences with Sri Janardhan Mitta sir. We joined under him around 4 years back. And it was very special for us because it was the first time we, you know, started learning something together as a couple. And especially we enjoyed each and every class with sir. It was a beautiful experience. He's always kind, calm and composed. One time I remember he gave one of his sitars to us for us to practice because we had only one sitar, so he wanted us to practice together. So it was a very, very kind thing for him to do. And then he's always very calm and composed, and that reflects in his music also.
And I remember when we joined under him, I was fully pregnant, and he didn't discourage me at all from learning. In fact, he said, it's very nice that you want to learn at this stage of your pregnancy. And he motivated me and said, it would be very nice for the baby as well. And he allowed me to sit in a very relaxed position. So he made sure we were very comfortable at all times. So we're very, very blessed and fortunate to be his students.
Namaste. To be able to sing or play an instrument is a God-given talent. Not many of us have this, but to be able to appreciate music is a blessing. Often, this comes from the guru that inspires and nurtures the student. I owe a large part of my ability to appreciate all kinds of music thanks to Janardhan sir and the time many of us have spent in his classes listening to him play while he taught us. I've been able to pass some of this down to my children as well, and for that I will be eternally grateful. I wish Janardhan sir the very best in life, and I hope he continues to inspire many, many more like me.
Myself Somaradhakrishnan. I'm proud to be a disciple of Panditji. Panditji is a dedicated, committed and passionate teacher. He is very modest, calm, simple and religious person. But at the same time, he's very firm, determined and serious while teaching. He sees to it that we play the notes perfectly, right notes, whether it be a sargam, taan or gat. I can't forget the perfect way that he taught us many ragas like Puri Dhaneshri, Bhageshri, Madhuvanti, Ahir Bhairav, etc., which I learned under him. His playing way is very unique, innovative in approach, but at the same time adhering to the tradition. His playing the means is just fascinating, and it's as if the sitar, the strings, they are singing alap. I'm fortunate enough to be tutored under him, even though for a short period.
I am S.A. Mani, one of the students of the great Guruji Pandit Janardhan Mittaji. He is a great sitarist in cine field as well as in the classical field. That too with, he is a very good sitarist, sitar teacher, and thank God to get such a Guruji.
I am Meera, and what a privilege to share a few words about Pandit Janardhanji, who was my Guruji more than 25 years ago when I was still in school. I still remember entering the class, which was in his house, such a sunny and airy place, and it was literally filled with music. And every room I used to see groups of students of a certain batch practicing what has been taught for the day. It was a place of real teaching and real learning, and he really, really cared what you got out of the class. And he taught each of us what we had to do, and we used to practice together, and then he brought us all out to play together to the accompaniment of a tabla artist, and he used to worry about every little nuance. I still remember when the position of the thumb and whether the knuckles were in the right angle and whether you're holding your hand right, everything mattered. He used to send home one Mr. Shamshad Bhai to even tune our sitars to practice the ragam that he wanted us to practice, because then the frets had to be moved and we were not as yet knowledgeable enough to do that, and he didn't want us to even practice with any kind of abhaswaram in that. And I remember the very act of sending somebody home to tune the sitar actually raised the sort of importance of what one was learning. And I always feel whether the journey with such teachers who care so much, whether it is a short journey or a long journey, whether we took it to its logical conclusion and whether you did your Arangetram, all that is irrelevant. I think this journey is more about the guru who came into your life a little bit and cast their shadow on you. Because I think great teachers bring to you a certain sensibility. They sort of raise the bar in you. They elevate you in a way which is almost intangible, but it is the quality of having such teachers in your life that actually changes who you are. That's what I feel. And For that, I am eternally grateful to Panditji for sharing his knowledge with us and having been some part of my childhood. And I feel that definitely made me a better person at the end of the day in a certain way that I cannot even quantify. So thank you so much, Guruji, and my humble namaskarams to you.
I am Girja Shekhar, fortunate to be a student of Pandit Janardhan Mitta. He is very caring and has a lot of patience. I am very lucky to have a guru like him. God bless him with lifelong happiness.
Hi, my name is Vijaya and I want to share some memories that I have of studying sitar with Pandit Janardhan Mitta. I was 16 years old at the time that I met Panditji, Guruji, and at that point I had been desperate to study sitar for many months. I had found a local teacher before I met Guruji, but I really wanted a deep grounding in ragas and in the sitar. I loved going to my lessons with Guruji. We worked in a sort of class situation. They were not private lessons. They were all in group situations. But he gave us all such individual attention that I felt it might as very well have been a private lesson. He made sure that all of our techniques was up to par. And I loved my lessons. Guruji was extremely strict, but also extremely kind. He made sure that we really got a thorough grounding in technique, in raga, in theory. He would explain everything and he would show very patiently how we should play the sitar. I think he took great pride in all of us and he was like a father figure for many of us. I cannot speak enough about how great I think my teacher has been to me and to all the other students who have studied with him. He is the essence of kindness and gentleness. He is the essence of love of music and true teacherliness towards his students. May you always be so, and may you live a long and happy life. May all the blessings of the world be yours, and thank you for everything you've given me.
Namaste, I am Sriram Kaushik, disciple of Panditji. Firstly, I would like to thank for giving me this opportunity to talk about my Guruji. For me, Guruji is very special to me because he inspired me the quality of life he is living. His dedication towards music, his neatness, his perfection in all aspects, each and every moment being with Guruji is a learning. Because Guruji not only teaches music, he also talks about his experiences, his memories in his music career. I really feel proud and great to be your disciple. My heartfelt wishes for you to stay hale and healthy in your life. Thank you Guruji, my pranams to you.
It has been a privilege to be a student of Pandit Janardhan Mitta ji and learn the sitar from him. He is a very open and very generous teacher, freely sharing his knowledge of Indian music with his students. One of the features of his music is that he not only gives the lessons, but also explains how the particular lesson is structured so that the student can then use that as a basis for further elaboration. He also encourages the students to listen to good music and other artists, and he wants the students to absorb the good things on what he or she hears from other artists. Another notable feature of his teaching is that at a very early stage, he exposes the students to ragas created by his guru Pandit Ravi Shankar and his guru Ustad Alauddin Khan sir, so that the students get a small glimpse into the genius of these masters. It is also very inspiring when he shares his experiences he had with his guru Pandit Ravi Shankar.
His acute sense for Shruti, the sense for tonality, not just for pitch, but for tonality of the instrument. How it sounds every second, which is really a remarkable quality in a musician. And to always watch out for a change in tonality and see what can be done about it. The other is his soft touch. One wouldn't find him concert after concert one can't find him letting the instrument jar, whether it is an alap or whether one is playing the taan. He's extremely soft with the instrument, and it's a remarkable thing for a studying musician to learn, for a practicing musician to always keep in mind. The other is his ability to not discriminate, to sort of look at the history of the instrument, its evolution, to the contributions of various ustads, various maestros, various pandits through the ages, without sort of differentiating between them, discriminating between them, or to sort of look at them with equanimity, with to look at those contributions through eras without a sense of, oh, this is better than that, this is more worthwhile than that, without that sense. And the other is his remarkable quality to maintain this side by side with this equanimity towards all past contributions, to also remember what the Senior Mahir Gharana, what his Guruji Pandit Ravi Shankarji sort of imparted, and to let that stay in his playing consistently. So this fine balance is something that one cannot help learn and sort of imbibe when one studies with him. It was a very sweet, memorable time being with him.
Namaskar, my name is Nalini Vinayak and I am a disciple of Pandit Janardhan Mitta. I feel very blessed that I was under the tutelage of my Guruji, a great sitar master and a teacher par excellence. My Guruji did never looked at the clock when he nurtured the talent in me to play the sitar. My Guruji also believed that while it is important to learn the technique of playing the sitar, the tradition of the Mahir Gharana, melody should never be forgotten. Melody is supreme, music is divine, riyas, practice, is meditation. I have carried these valuable nuggets that I learned from my Guruji throughout my life and in my career as a musician. My success in becoming the director of the Indian Music Ensemble School of Music, Florida State University, can only be credited to the hours that my Guruji spent selflessly training me to play the sitar. I wish my Guruji all the very best, and I pray for my Guruji Pandit Janardhan Mitta and his family for wonderful health and great peace throughout their lives.
Namaskara, I'm Shankari. I've been learning from Guruji for the past 5 years. If I have to tell about Guruji in one word, he's unparalleled, both as a person as well as a guru. As a teacher, he never tells us what to do. Rather, he gives us the right direction and the right kind of encouragement and motivation that at the end of every learning session, we would feel like it's a self-discovery. What is more inspiring about him is he never stops learning. Be it music or any subject, he's always there for the quest of knowledge. He's a great conversationist. At the end of the conversation, there will be a lot of takeaways for us, not only from music, but of varied subjects. I really thank God for giving me such a great guru in this life, and my sincere pranams to my Guruji for always being my constant motivation. Thank you.
I'm one of Guruji's students, and I learned from him for a couple of years. I used to look forward to going for the classes because, one, he was a very warm soul, and I used to enjoy learning from him. I'm very grateful for having learned from him because of the kind of varied background he has in both classical music and as well as light music. I'm very thankful for having learned from him, and I wish that he would play for a very long time.